So in order for you to design what kind of cable I need, you need to look at what? The axial forces. To decide what kind, I want to pull a truck. And I have this thin rope. Can I use that or not to pull a truck? When we go calculate the axial forces. Now when we deal with the shear means for me is this wall is going to crack and separate up down. One side is going to be lower than the other, and this happens in your carpentry, in your kitchen sometimes, in your garage. You have some wood loaded with ever for 100 years, my mother leaves something on the shelves, correct? And for a sudden you find that the door doesn't close well. And the door is like, from the, that is kind of shearing. And in this case you need to design, so I need to look for maximum shear. Moment, it's going to create a deformation to a limit that if I keep pushing on this, I will break it by the moment, correct? This is a moment. So you don't need the beam to be broken, correct? This is why, how you design it. When we deal with diagrams, we are going to do the same step like in here. The only thing is we need to worry not only for one portion. Here we are dealing about one single specific particular point. Go find a G. Okay? Now I'm dealing with the whole beam. From that column to this column, there is a beam in here. Or that beam. Do you see it? From this column to that column. This beam, I'm not going to ask you find the moment or the shear at that point, white point, or in the middle. I'm going to ask you find the shear and the moment all over the beam. Because this is how we design, to find the maximum, okay? So when we deal with that, write the steps. First step, you need first to find the reactions. Find the reactions. The second one is find cuts. One, reactions. Two, cuts. Cuts means every time load changes. This is tells you how many cuts you need to do with that beam. Okay? Free body diagram for each cut. Apply the arrows as shown previously, okay? Then equation the equilibrium. Number six. Substitute for extremities. What extremities means, we are going to make a cut, and this cut represents this portion. Okay, so I will, extremities here is zero, and here is half meter, so I will 0.5 meter, okay? Then I will move to make a cut from here to here. This is zero for me, this is 20 centimeters, so I will replace for 0 and 20. Then I move to this. This is 0 and this is 30. I put just the extreme of the beam.
So is that like just talking about length?
Draw diagram.
What does 5 say?
What's what's that?
Verse 5.
Equation of equilibrium.
Equation of.
That's what it's
Yeah,
it's
mm-hmm.
Apply the equations of equilibrium.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So this is the shear, and now we are not going to draw the force for the axial forces according to your book. So we are going to do only shear and moment. Here is a beam. This beam is supported here by a ruler. Supported here by a pen. This beam is loaded by this force here, and is loaded here by this moment, and it's loaded here by this force. This is 100 pound a foot. This is 700 pound, and this is 500 pound foot. Dimensions. Okay, for those who draw the beam at the bottom of their page, they need to redraw the beam at the next page on the top. Okay? Draw a line here, and the line here, do not use. Okay? Because you are going to draw the shear and moment diagram underneath the beam. Your book doesn't show this. Your book says you can draw it wherever you want. I want to see it underneath the beam. Why? Because you can see the changes. You can see the forces. You can see. If you draw them separately, you are not going to learn anything. You are not going to get it. Why is this? How is this? So don't follow your book procedure by draw it any place. Draw it underneath because there is a relationship. I want you. You are going to tell me there is a relationship in here. This is the relationship. But if you draw them in different separate ways, you are not going to track. Okay? Let's start with step number one. Find the reactions. Reactions are, this is A, B, C, D. At A, I have only AY. At C, I have here CY and CX. Even if it is zero, I want to see it. You assume it's zero. You know it is zero. Put it there, and then sum of forces on X equals zero. This is CX equals zero. In the final, if you lose some point like this, you are not going to see me and tell me, okay, I will give you 1 point back. You lose it forever, so forget about reimbursing you. So CX means it's zero. You know it's zero. Show it in your free body diagram. Then this is not going to take lots of time to do these things, okay? Sum of the moment at either A or C, correct? Which one do you want? Sum of the moment at
C.
About C? C equals zero. Let's see what we have. We have 100 times 3 times 1.5. Agree on this?
Mm-hmm.
And this is negative. Everybody, I want you to understand what I put this.
What's the
This one represents a force here.
Oh, right.
This force is 100 times 3. This distance here is 1.5. Everybody?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Again, this is very important to understand it because we are going to deal later on with, instead of 1.5, we are going to deal with x because we don't know where is this cut. Is it here? Is it here? Is it here? Is it here? X is variable. So we are going to deal with these numbers with x's. Okay? And this is very important to understand it now, how we put 100 times 3 times 1.5. Okay? 700 times 5 is positive. AY times 9 is negative. Positive 500, the moment, equals 0. Everybody agrees on this?
Mm-hmm.
From here, we have one unknown called AY. What is AY, please?
I got it. 427. Yeah, 494.
Two people got 494? One go 494. Sum of forces on Y?
I got 390.
I got 394.
394. Sum of forces on Y. 700 is negative. 100 times 3 is negative. AY is positive. CY is positive equals 0. Then CY equal.
Six or six,
correct? This force is 700. This force is 300. That's 1,000 heading down. AY and CY. One is 394.
Yeah.
Okay. Everybody okay with what we did so far? This is something from previous lecture, so everybody is supposed to be very familiar with this so far, correct? Now, next step is cuts. We said we will do cuts every time the load changes. Let's draw a cut in here. Cut one. Where I should draw cut two? Cut two. Agree? Everybody?
Mm-hmm.
And cut three. Everybody? Ask me why. Every time the load changes, we need a new cut. So start from the beam here. I have load here. AY, I consider it a load, okay, like external load. I have a moment here. and put a cut here. This cut could be X here, could be 0, could be half foot, could be 1 foot, 2, 3, 4. Okay? Then I get a new load. Load 700. I need a cut after it. This cut going in here all the way till I need another cut. I will another force. I have a force here and I have force here, then I need another. Is this clear? Now, we start with each one, we make a cut, and we draw three body diagram for each one. So cut one is going to be like this. Here is the beam, here is the cut. What forces I should put in here? We are not doing the axis. M1 and N1. Other books call it V. Your book call it N? Correct?
Our book calls it V.
V?
Yeah, I just see V.
V. Okay. V1 and M1. What forces we have here? We have this force here of 500. And we have AY here of 394. What else we need for this free body diagram? This distance from here to here, starting from here, going this way is X. And this is important, very important, where the X starts. Because the cut, I will consider it right in here, here, or here, or here. So X increasing in this direction. Okay? Put the arrows.
Yes. Is V1 a shear?
V is the shear. Some
so if it's on the left side, it should be pointing up.
Is it pointing up, left side? Left side is pointing down. If we do a mistake here, this is down. This is up. All the time, the left side is
left
down.
Side down.
Yes.
So our previous question is two, we should change that, right?
Yes. Left side is down. Left side, all the time, the left side. Left side is down, moment in here.
Okay.
Right side is up, moment is here. Okay? What else? Let's apply the equations of equilibrium. Equations of equilibrium. Sum of forces on Y equals 0. I have 394 is positive. V1 is negative equals 0. Or V1 equals 394. Sum of forces, sum of the moment at cut 1 equals 0. I have 500 is positive, correct? M1 is positive. 394 is negative. Times what?
X.
Times X. That's why we need to deal now with X as variable equals 0 from here. M1 equal 394x minus 500. Agree? Everybody? 394x minus 400, 500, correct? We said now we need to apply little table in here, X. V, M. table. For V1, when x equals 0, x equals 0, right in here, what do we have for V1?
394.
394. What is if x equals 4?
394.
Still 394, because it's not connected to x, correct? So 394. The moment when x equals 0, the moment is negative 500. Extremist is at 4. Now we go to 4 here. Replace 4 from the other one, x equals 4 here. So this is going to be 394 times 4, negative 500.
1076.
1076. Let's come back here. That's why I told you don't try it underneath in here. So you need to show this is the V, this is the moment. For x equals 0, 394, we need this line, we need this line. 394 positive. 394, line between them, everything above the line is positive. That's the shear diagram. The moment,
yes.
Here is negative 500, and the other side is 1076. What kind of line to connect them? Look at the equation here. The equation says 394x minus 500. This is a linear equation. Takes a straight line, correct? Straight line from here to here. This is lower side is negative. Underneath the line, all the time is negative. And above the line, all the time is positive. Cut. Finish this. And if you have questions about it, before we move to the second cut. The second cut between B and C, correct? Which side do you want to work with? Now, we don't work from cut to cut. We work from the end of the beam till the cut. Done with cut number one. We started from the end of the beam till the cut. Now cut number two, we started from A to here, or we started from B to here. Which side I should take? Left side or right side?
Yeah.
Left side. So cut number two. We have 500 here. We have a Y here. We have 700 here. We have M2 here, V2 here. This distance here is 4 feet. This distance here, starting from here going there, is X. Because now the cut number two, is going to be here, 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 here. Okay? That's why the x, the variable. I don't know exactly where to take it. Everybody okay with this three-band diagram?
Mm-hmm.
For cut two, sum of forces on one equals L. What do we have here? Negative 700, negative V2, and positive 394 equals L. Or V2 equals
306.
404?
Negative 306.
306.
404.
306.
Negative? 406.
306.
306. Or 306. Negative?
Uh-huh.
Moment. Sum of the moment at cut 2 equals 0. I have 500 is positive. M2 is positive. I have 700 times x is positive. 394 times 4 plus x is negative equals 0. Agree on this statement? From here, M2 equals.
Calculator and see, check my numbers.
What's
that?
What's
that?
It's correct.
Correct?
Okay. A little table here. X equals 0. X equal, what's the next number? 5. And we have here V2 and M2. For V2, negative 306, negative 306. There's no x involved with the V, correct? For the moment, when the moment is 0, I have 1076. When the distance is 5, put 5 here. Negative 306 times 5, positive 1076. What is that equal?
Negative 454.
Negative?
454.
454. Let's draw the moment here and shear diagrams. Diagram. With the shear, negative 306, negative 306, something like that. 306, 306, negative. The moment, when it is 0, I get 1076. I have here 1076, so I connect with this point. The following one is negative 454. you see what I did here so far. The last cut. What do you think I should take? The left side or the right side of the last cut?
Right side.
The right side is going to be easier, correct? So it's not needed to draw too many forces, too many stuff. So these here, the cut is here. We have these forces here. These forces are 100 and Burford. That's it. Now we need to draw M3 and V3. Correct? Nothing else. Only important thing that we need to show here is X. X starts from here going this way. And again, X where it starts, which direction is going is very important when you draw the diagrams. Sum of forces on one. Equals zero, we have V3 is positive, negative 100x equals zero. Or V3 equals 100x. Correct? Everybody?
Yes, sir.
It's to the moment now. Sum of the moment. At cut 3 equals 0. Put your finger there. You have M3 is negative. Correct? You have 100 x squared over 2 is negative equals 0.
And everybody says,
what is this x squared over 2? Correct? If I replace this distributed force with one force here, this force is 100x. Correct? Everybody? This distance here, x over 2, x over 2. 100, 100 times x. Times x over 2 equals 0. This is x squared over 2. Or m3 equals negative 50x squared. Can you see that? We will do other problem on this. Just I would like you to understand what we're doing here. This is the main idea. Is the area here represented by one concentrated force is 100x and x to x over 2, x over 2. Table, x equals 0, x equal. What is the other x?
3.
V3. M3. Let's see. V for x equals 0. V equals 0. For x equals 3, V equals 300. Everybody agrees on this?
Yes.
Let's look at the moment. If x equals 0, the moment equals
0.
X equals 3. 450. Let's go here and draw the diagrams now. table. X equals 0 for the shear. The shear is 0. Where is my 0? It's right in here, not here. Correct? Now the X coming from here, look, coming this way. So this is the 0 here. For X equal, it's a 300 positive is here. Distance is 0, x equals 0, the moment here is 0, correct? Here is 0. For, it's negative 450, which it is this point here. What kind of line? It's a quadratic equation, so it is?
Parabolic.
Now, parabola could be, or could be like this, correct? For the forces hitting down, is going to create in the beam deflection down like this, correct? Forces hitting down, so the parabolic is this one, not this one. Good? How I can draw this? Let's study our beam. That's why I want the forces to be here. Let's start our beam. I have here a concentrated force, Ay, with a 394. Do I have Ay 394? I have a 394 here. Can you see that? No forces, no changes I go to here. Here, sorry. This is the force. The Ay, going this way. No force still here. Here, I have a force of 700. From this point, you have 700. Add them together. Can you see 700? This is what we call it, a drop in the diagram. When you have a drop, means you have a concentrated force. Other than that, your lines should be connected, no drops. Let's go from here. Going this way, I have CY here. What's the value of CY?
606.
606. Do we have from here to here 606?
Yes.
Going back to the 0. Start from 0, ending at 0. Whenever we have concentrated forces, we have drops. Let's look at the moment. I have a concentrated moment here, it's 500. I have a 500 in here. Can you see that? Mm-hmm. Then, no other moment, so I go till here. There is no concentrated moment. Go back, go up to 0. Start from 0, end from 0. One drop for one concentrated moment. Is this clear? Now, the question is, where is the maximum moment? The maximum moment all the time is at the place where the shear drops from positive to negative. Here drops it from positive to negative, and here drops it from positive to negative, correct? Underneath these lines, I have 1076, and I have negative 454. So the maximum moment, is going to be 1076. What is the maximum shear?
394.
For your design, if you have a moment going from here to here, okay? And you get positive and negative. What is the positive and negative? Positive and negative is something trying to rotate the beam to break it in this direction, that's negative, in this direction, that's positive. For both conditions, the negative positive is only direction of up or down. You need to design your beam according to the maximum moment. Doesn't matter where is that. You want to take a few minutes a break or giving you another 20 minutes, another small problem and go home? What do you want?
Go home.
Another problem, go home.
Yeah. Okay. Let's look here. I want to find a problem that I need to find. Questions? Yes, if you have questions, go ahead.
Or just so in practicality, this is just a plan like this.